Today I have got for you 7 purchasing hacks. These are specific strategies. If you follow, you will make sure that you will save a lot of money in purchasing. And where all are restaurant owners able to save money? It is a topic which can be carried out for hours together, for years together. But today I've bought for you a training which is going to help you understand the power of saving money by purchasing at low cost. Hi, this is Gopal Kamath. I'm a restaurant owner and the founder of Restaurant Launch Formula, where we teach you how to set up your successful restaurants and take it to new heights by implementing workable, practical strategies to help you to understand the business better and take the right decisions so that you take your restaurant to the next level. Today I have got for you 7 purchasing hacks. These are specific strategies. If you follow, you will make sure that you will save a lot of money in purchasing, and that will add to the bottom line as far as profits are concerned. Let's check out the first one. Always buy bulk. This is like a no-brainer. If you are not in a position to buy from a local market, then comes the second point: buy from a wholesale market. Of course, you should never buy from a local market. Always buy from a wholesale market and buy in bulk. The money which you save if you buy in bulk in 25 kg bags, 50 kg bags is that if you calculate it and if you multiply it into the number of kilos per year, the money which you save is tremendous, and you have to buy in bulk and you have to buy from wholesale markets. The third one is standardize. Always keep a standardized quality of purchasing products which you are using for your recipes. Don't try to change it according to the pricing. The more you change it according to pricing, if this thing is cheaper, if that thing is cheaper, that will change your taste of your ultimate product. Of course, the kitchen department is not going to let you to do that, but make sure you stick to the same standard irrespective of the cost, because ultimately it is about saving the cost, but most importantly it is about maintaining the quality of your food product for your customers. The fourth one is all about pay later. Try to take some credit from your suppliers, try to take some credit from your vendors, so that you can take an advantage of using that ultimate cash flow and using it to keep your restaurant fluid, so that you can pay your rent on time, you can remove your profit on time, you can pay yourself on time, your salaries on time, your electricity bill on time, and keep it smooth so that there are no tensions as far as cash management is concerned. Then the fifth one is all about FIFO. FIFO stands for first in, first out. It is a method of making sure that if the departments are ordering some products, you have to first make sure whether the existing products are on the verge of ending or not. If they are not ending, then it doesn't make sense to order the remaining, because there is a problem of shelf life also, and there is a problem of requirement also. So FIFO is a method. It is mostly used in kitchen, but you have to look into it. And then comes the sixth one, which is checking the price. The vendors who are selling you these food products are very, very smart. They will try to take advantage of you. They will try to bill you a little higher so that they can earn more profits while selling you this food products and ingredients. So make sure you have a very, very sharp focus on this. And the seventh purchasing hack, which is a surprise, is all about maintaining the standards and quality and cleanliness in the storage space where you purchase. I know this is an internal point, but it is very, very important. If you are purchasing stuff in quantity and if it is not maintained properly, if there is rat infestation, if there is other infestation, you will lose the advantage of what you have earned by purchasing it in bulk. So make sure you use that to your advantage. Keep your storage process clean and use this and all the other tips to purchase very, very efficiently in your restaurant business. Thank you so much for watching up till now.
I hope you guys loved the video, and I'm sure this video and the information is going to help you to open a successful restaurant of your own. Now, if you want to go more deeper and have an in-depth understanding about the restaurant business, I suggest you join my 5 days WhatsApp class. The link is in the description section under this video. And in this 5 days WhatsApp class, I take you step by step to the foundational pillars of restaurant business and the food business. What should be your concept? What should be your location? What should be your thinking like a restaurateur's, like our restaurant owner thinks? And how should you match it with the right type of target clientele? These are the core pillars on which the foundation of your successful restaurant holds. So if you really want to take it to a deeper level and have a better understanding about the restaurant business, go to the link in the description section and sign up for my 5-day WhatsApp class. There is a small fee which I charge so that you guys are serious and you can take it and implement it to open a successful restaurant of your own. So see you in the 5 days WhatsApp class. Thank you so much for seeing the video up till now, and see you in my next video. Thank you so much. This is Gopal Kamat signing off. Bye-bye. Love from you.